Greetings, fellow Earthlings, welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. We are currently in Menevia. Now, the reason that we are here in this godforsaken province of the Iliac Bay is the simple fact that we need to figure out where Lysandus' tomb is. And what I'm hoping to achieve right now is to get some quests from the Pirates Guild to not only get promoted to the next rank, which I do believe is Champion, and in the process, discover where Lysandus' tomb is. So, since there are not a lot of tombs here in Menevia that for which we can get quests, I'm hoping that we can actually get a quest that leads us to his tomb. So, as a result, I'll be declining any of the quests that don't take us into, you know, the dungeons, and I will be sticking to the ones that will potentially take us into dungeons. With that being said, let's go ahead and enter the Pirates Guild. Sturdy shells cobbled together. Alright, let me save in front of this guy here. And let us go ahead and talk to him. I like you, kid. This assignment ain't just for anyone. Seems there's a flock of flying carnivores, harpies, who are making a bunch of traveling merchants real nervous. Will 656 gold get you over to ruins of Wickcroft Palace and a little hacking and slashing? Now, here's the thing. This has already told us the name of the dungeon that we headed to, supposed to be headed to, and it's called the Ruins of Wickford Palace. Now, Wickcroft Palace, actually, sorry, that's my bad. But that isn't exactly Lysandus' tomb, so we're gonna have to decline this one. And let's keep trying to get a quest from him. No, this is the wild animal quest line. Okay, I have a relatively menial job. Nope, this is again the quest for giant rodents. A certain merchant needs to have a monster, a gargoyle to be precise, dispatched. The pay is modest, 651 gold pieces. Can I have your help in this matter? Sure. It seems this merchant hired a wizard to build him a grand mansion, then the poor fool tried to cheat the mage of his wages. The wizard grew angry and animated one of the stone gargoyles on the new mansion. It has been attacking the merchant carelessly. Go to the ruins of old Kinging Hovel and kill the thing. You've got 7 days to complete the task. Now, we can do this, or I just figured out that we can actually just reload the save and keep farming it until we get Lysandus' tomb from this guy. Again, the simple fact of the matter is that it'll just be treated as any other dungeon in the area, and we just need to keep cycling through the quests until we can get it. Ruins of Tower Wickham? Nah. Not there. Giants that want killing. Okay. At the stronghold, the Duninac excavation. You know, I would rather go ahead and complete all of these other dungeons once I do have the location of Lysandus' tomb. So this might take a while, so what I'll do is I'll just cut ahead to when I do find it. Okay, finally we got it. Alright. Something's come up. I don't know who else could handle it but you, Grimfangs. This is bad critter in Lysandus' tomb, a Daedroth. Now, I ain't lying. No one knows why it's there, but everyone wants it gone. For 697 gold, you think you could handle it, Grimfangs? Yes, yes I could. Now, hey, alright, your funeral, Grimfangs. Listen, knock off that Daedroth and get back here in 9 days for your reward. I don't know how long that thing's gonna be around, so you're gonna wanna move your ass. And listen to me on this, Grimfangs. Go prepared for a hell of a fight. I know, they're gonna be plenty of undead there. Now, the reason that I wanted to get to Lysandus' tomb like this is simply because, well, I didn't want to cheat. Like, I tested it out, and yes, I can cheat my way through it. But I did not want to cheat. That is the reason why I decided to do things the way I did things. And let us go ahead and equip this axe for this. We might as well get our axe up. Yeah, it's a little lagging right now. Long blade is, something else altogether. So, let us go ahead and travel to Lysandus' tomb since we... Now, the thing is, even if we fail this mission, it's alright because we have finally found the location of Lysandus' tomb. So, actually, I just realized there should have been an extra S at the end, apostrophe S. Alright. So, equipping the axe and headed towards Lysandus' tomb, then. It should be somewhere over here. We just can't see where it is because of the fog. Dense fog. Maybe we should travel to Lysandus' tomb again. And yeah, we'll travel again. So this time we head south, and we are clearly in the area where the tomb might be. Oh, there it is. I could not see it for the life of me the previous time around, I swear. Just the way that things work in Daggerfall, to be honest. And this seems like a really humble little thing here. The windows are blacked out though, so I can't really make out what's inside. So let us save here and let us enter this godforsaken place. We'll have to come back here anyway, so might as well get a feel for it, I suppose. Okay, there are lots of statues here. Interesting. Very interesting. I mean, the main dungeons do have a very different feel to them in this game. I will say that much. They do feel like completely different. Let me just drop something here. Cool. Now I wonder where the damn Daedroth could be. Okay, this is skull. I don't know what this does, but this is definitely teleporting, so I'm just gonna save in the emergency slot right here, and I'm gonna try touching this. Because it's definitely gonna... Yeah. It's I thought it would take me somewhere, and it did. It did, in fact, take me somewhere. Really? I got paralyzed right off the bat like that? Can you, like, stop hitting me? Thank you. I mean, I get it, you're supposed to be hitting me, but yeah, let me just take that cloak as well. I don't know what powers it has, but it definitely has some kind of powers. So I'm gonna take it. This opened another door for me. I have no idea where this door goes, but at least the door opened. So I suppose that's a good thing. It opens into another chamber. I think I know this dungeon module, and I'm not a typically huge fan of it. Nothing here. Good to just mark it off the map then. I'll just go with and save here because, well, I feel a little more comfortable that way. At this point, I've got no idea where I'm going, and I did not expect a rat of all things to be here. Now we can go left. I'm pretty sure there's going to be like an entire hallway to the left. We can go upstairs as well. We have already covered that area behind us. Let me just save here. Let's try going upstairs. The audio glitch. I did not mean to do that, but at least it was just a bat. And I'm getting better at climbing. It is something that I've noticed. That climbing is not as difficult for me anymore. That's a zombie. These guys hit hard. Look at that guy. I mean, every single shot is a crit. There are enemies nearby. When they say enemies, they are actually referring to... Well, bats, for the most part. Before I go back upstairs, I'm just gonna go this way. This is an empty room. I'm assuming a rest spot for us. For us peasants. I'm gonna save here. Now, we can proceed forward or we can head down there. Let's proceed forward, I guess. I see a bat. No, bats are not the enemies that I'd expected in this dungeon, to be honest. I was expecting far more difficult enemies. Zombies? Okay. I guess I'm strong enough to tackle zombies as well now? Well, guess what? We're going upstairs anyway. And we hit that rat square in the face. Okay, so this is where we came out from. And that is the path that we did not take. So let us go ahead and take the other path here, which leads downstairs. That was more of a circle, a loop that we just took. Okay, there's a stone here to denote like something. I don't know what, but something. There's some loot there, which does not bode well, actually. Loot never bodes well. Oh, I presume it is loot. Seems to be just another way to mark the path for us. No enemies here. Okay, just a giant. Why are there giant bats in this map? Should we continue exploring this level? That seems to be a hidden door. Nah. Yeah, let's go downstairs. Let's go downstairs and check what's around the corner for us. Some pieces of broken wood. Now, we have two options here. Let's take the route on the right. That just takes us upstairs. And I don't know where it takes us out. And I'm running out of means to mark the places I've visited already. Okay, so this takes us back here. Shall we go ahead and... Yeah, I mean, this seems to be just a room. Might as well mark this off. I wanted to be grab mode, not interact mode. I accidentally clicked on that. This dungeon module, it seems very basic, to be honest. I thought there would be like vampire ancients and liches and all sorts of things in here, but... I mean, I think I'm sort of disappointed. I thought it would be more difficult than this. I mean, don't get me wrong, I am thankful that there's like pretty easy stuff down here, but I'm also sort of disappointed at the same time, you know? Oh shit, there are three zombies here. At least one of them is not aware of my presence. Four zombies? No, that's just a giant bat. I think it's like stuck inside of this crate here. I can also hear rats. Or I don't know whether that's just the bat sound. Could just be the bat sound, to be honest. Of course, we're gonna take the gold and we're gonna take something to mark our journey with as well. Okay, what is this round shield? We have no idea what it does, but it is enchanted, so I'm gonna keep it. Sometimes I wish I had powers to identify things. Ebony longsword, that is very nice, but these people were actually soldiers. So, thus far, from the looks of it, it's a pretty simple map to play through, from what I can tell. It's not that difficult. Not that difficult at all. Which is surprising, because I thought that, you know, Lysandus' Tomb, it's one of the major dungeons in this game. And considering all the dungeons we have been to thus far, this should have been far more difficult. I wonder why it's not. I hear zombies. I don't know where they are though. Okay, so that's a ghost. The ghost did not know that I was there. That's a zombie. I mean, the biggest threat that I've faced thus far is a zombie. And that's not really a big threat, if you know what I'm saying. So we came up from there and we did like a whole loop. I wonder if this takes us back there. I suppose it does. Just not through a very direct sort of path. Hidden door? No? Okay, if you say so. Unless... No, typically moving walls have like a totally different texture to them. So I doubt that this is a moving wall of sorts. That guy's dead. And what would this be? Potion of invisibility, don't really need that. I'm not a mage. I'm not looking to play as a mage. And I'm not going to be playing as a mage, so... Okay, that side's done. This, I presume, is going to take us here. Yes. Yes, it does. Although this is like a new place that we have not seen before. 15 gold. I'll take the Daedroth hut. I initially thought that was an apple, but that's actually a Daedroth hut. I wonder what... things it is used for crafting. Have we been in there? No, we have not. This is a dead end. I mean, thus far the dungeon exploration is pretty simple. To be honest, I was sort of dreading coming here. Who's died? Did not expect you of all things there, but thankfully you did die. And I'm just walking around aimlessly at this point, not really following any specific structure to exploring this dungeon right now. Just getting a feel for things the way they are in this game. Really? I thought I heard a bat as well, but oh well, guess that was just my imagination. Pretty sure I'm not supposed to go there. I don't think a Daedroth is going to be underwater. But if by the end we cannot find where the Daedroth is, we might as well head there. Might as well tread water a bit. Okay, now these are the places which I find utterly confusing. This should be an empty room. With nothing in it, just a rest area of sorts. I haven't saved in a while, so let me just go ahead and update a previous save of mine. Did not see this guy rolling up on me. Reaction. Right there. I mean, I don't particularly need a potion of reaction because I've got boots for that express purpose, but... I think the past few dungeon crawls have traumatized me to where I'm being pretty jumpy around every corner. And I think that's the intended effect that Daggerfall is supposed to have on you. Arena, I mean, that was more of a very frustrating experience because you just kept dying a lot, and especially as a warrior, there was no other way apart from, you know, dying for you. Brutal decorations. I wonder if this is what you would call brutalist aesthetic. Hi there. I don't know what's behind me, so that's why I took you out first. Nothing personal there. Okay. Oh, another zombie. Rob zombie. That's a band, I do believe. I haven't heard any of their songs, but I have heard their name. Resist poison. Again, I'm not really going to be making potions as much as purchasing them. Because I don't really have access to a potion maker either. To be making potions. Okay, now I hear something. Objection level right there. The ghost died. Okay, I think I was just hearing this ghost here. I'm just walking around aimlessly, really. Just going where the road takes me, because I feel safe enough to do that in this dungeon. Ironically, Lysandus' tomb is easy. Or maybe I'm speaking too soon. Maybe I've not experienced the more difficult enemies of this dungeon yet. Maybe that's why I'm saying this. But it's mostly just zombies and rats and bats and ghosts, and that's pretty much it. I was sort of expecting tougher enemies, you know? Something that would make you dread going into another dungeon the next time around. The way it typically is with the Daggerfall. Picking up all the loot that I can, so that I can finally begin marking the places that I've been to on the map. So this side is cleared. I can hear more zombies, but zombies is all I hear, and that's pretty much the thing that I was saying, that I don't know whether it's because I teleported or what, but Lysandus' tomb seems pretty easy. I really do hope I don't jinx it, but yeah, it does seem pretty easy. Have we been here? No, we have not. Checking corners. That's something that this game has given me. Check corners. As if it's a first person shooter. As if that's gonna make any difference at all. But yeah, that is what this game has taught me. Check your corners. You never know what's gonna jump out of you. Jump out of the corner at you. Is that a... I did not see this guy. But that's just how ghosts are designed in this game. I mean, given the general level of darkness that you're usually typically subjected to, you don't really know where the ghosts are. This looks like a hidden door of sorts. Is it? No, it's not. Just my imagination. No, we're going here, right? Yes. Ooh, there's a trap door there. Most likely... Wait. Did it just open when I stepped on it? That is... some trapdoor I've never seen before. Because trapdoors generally don't open when you step on them, you know? Resist shock, resist frost. Yeah, might as well keep them. They're useful potions. How much does this cactus weigh? Half a kilogram. Fine. This also... What is this? Mummy wrappings. Oh, these are mummy wrappings! I thought they were like pieces, strips of leather or something. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna save here because I don't want to override the emergency save. And yeah, nothing happens, fine. Okay, so we have checked this side out. Nothing is there. On this side, at least. Because if this was Draeny Tower, we would be facing stuff like zombies, and not zombies, I mean, zombies are what we're facing right here. If this was Draeny Tower, we would be up against vampires and vampire ancients and liches, and even the fighter's guild quest that took us to kill Daedroth the previous time around, the Dust of Restful Death, it took us... Oh, I see. It took us into a place that had ancient liches, not just regular old liches, ancient liches. So this is actually shocking to me right now, like quite surprising, the fact that we're getting such easy enemies for this turn. Free action somewhere? Did I miss one? Maybe we're just out of those potions? Ah yes, right there. Oh, fuck off. Now, which way have we not gone? We came from that way, so I suppose we go this way. This way? No, that way. And it's a dead end. Well, good thing that we got that cleared. Do you have anything on you? Oh, you do! Potion of Levitation. Again, I don't have access to a potion maker, and the Mage's Guild will not take me in because I'm too dumb for them. That's what they said. That's not what I'm saying, that's what they said. So, yeah. Now, where were we? We checked that side, we came from that side, so the only option remaining to us right now is to head straight, I suppose. I'm also liking how the dungeon, you know, the layout of the dungeon isn't particularly confusing. Sometimes these bodies tend to have loot, and usually when they have loot, they've got pretty amazing loot. So it doesn't really hurt to check them. There was a little bit of an issue with that texture there. I can just mark this off as a place that is, you know, sealed off. I hear zombies, and that's really all there is to this section here. Let me just go ahead and update the save, because I haven't saved here in a while. Let's head this way. I do believe there might be a zombie here. Let's go ahead and check this. Oh, okay. Let's go up there then first. Pretty sure this is just a restroom. Probably has a zombie in it or a ghost. No? Nothing? Okay. It does tell me that there are enemies nearby. I can't hear them, but apparently there are enemies nearby. Oh, there you are. No wonder I couldn't rest. No wonder Lysandus can't rest either. I mean, who would be able to rest with all these zombies screaming into his ear? Oh, look at this guy. Just roll out. And shoot. I think there was something else in there. No? Oh, I guess I was just looking at this thing here. Resting here. I have to say that while I like this new slower pace, this easier difficulty, it is making the dungeon crawl a little bit boring. But then again, seriously, one guy paralyzes me and the other starts whacking me. I guess this is what you call teamwork. I wouldn't know that because I've been adventuring solo all this time. So, you guys realize what I was talking about when I said that the zombies had heard? Yeah, that. Let me go ahead and rest. Go back into this room and rest my ass off again. And we will update this here save. My long list should have gotten upgraded by now, but it hasn't. Makes you wonder why that is the case. Okay, this is like some sort of a summoning circle right here. I don't know why, but this dungeon seems to have a lot of character. Far more so than the rest of the dungeons that we've been to thus far. This looks like a movable wall. We just need to figure out the mechanism to make it move. The reason I'm saying that is because you can see the torch glowing behind it. But this wall is just, it does not match the texture of the wall, texture of the rest of the area around it. This wall definitely moves. We need to figure out how to move it. Maybe the mechanism is on the other side. Really? Really? I'm burning through, like, potions of free action. And I think that's just the curse of playing as a fighter. as a melee class. Like, if I was probably playing as something like a ranged class, or like, not even ranged class, like a magic class, I would not be facing the same issue. The ranged classes don't really matter a lot in this game. You can't do as much damage with a bow and arrow, and okay, this is stretched out all over the place. Let me just go and save here, because I don't know where to go from this point onwards, and we'll check this side out, because it seemed curious. The textures were pretty stretched out, indicative of the fact that it was not planned to be that way. Oh, sorry to see you there. Too bad I can't help you. Like, as much as I would like to, I just practically cannot help you. Is the thing. Thank you for opening that door for me. Too bad these shelves aren't lootable, otherwise we could have like grabbed a weapon from the damn dungeon itself that we've come to crawl. Okay, it's a bat. Nothing here. I'm quite certain this is going to be a very long dungeon crawl. And it does seem to hold up its reputation thus far of being a potentially long dungeon crawl. I think this is the way we are supposed to be going, because yeah, we haven't been this side yet. But this seems to be just a dead end. So this door, as you can see, is like, this is like a proper dead end. This is not really going to open up to anything. But that door, I do feel like it is going to open up to something. I don't know what, but something. Let me go ahead and update this in here. Save. Let's head back down. Let's see where things take us. We had already checked that side. We checked this room as well. And that side was a dead end from, at least for now, because we don't know how to open that door up. Like, this wall here, this wall moves, I'm certain of that. But we don't know how to get it to move yet. So I guess we go back this way. And see what else we can do. If we have completely covered this area, we might as well go ahead and explore some place we have not covered. So that is where we came from, I do believe. And yes, this is the site that we are yet to explore. Let's go ahead and explore it. I hear rats. Probably a rat or two behind this door here. Just a rat. Rats and zombies. That's... well, I think we've already been there before. I feel like there's only another rat in there, because otherwise... well, the door was locked though, so I can't really jump to a conclusion that there's nothing behind it. Because typically, beasts such as rats and tigers can't really open doors for you, so you need to open doors for them. So if you know that there's like a... this also seems like a moving wall. What's going on? Or is it just mirroring the texture outside of this room? I guess that's the case. It's just mirroring the texture outside of this room, yeah. Now there are two paths that we can choose, and for whatever reason I feel like we've already come here before. That is probably because we have come here before. One of the places that we have not explored yet is this here side. So this is where we stepped into the, you know, the dungeon to crawl it. And we have not gone down there yet. So alright, let's go ahead and clear out that part of the map as well. I do not know what's down there, but I sure would love to. Let's go here first. Okay, so we've already been here, because that's why there's a dead zombie there. We have been that way as well, from the looks of it. Oh no, we were up there, right. Maybe we should go back up and finish exploring this side? Yes. is probably going to lead us to this here location. And now that we have got that part covered, we have not checked out that side. Right behind us, there's a hidden door here. Okay, let's check it out. Let's see what this door has to offer us. Nothing much, but just some loot. And what is this thing? It's a talisman? It's just a talisman. I'm gonna save the game here. And we will trudge onwards. Onwards into darkness, gentlemen. Onwards into darkness. So from the looks of it, there are a few areas that we have not yet covered. And the way to get to them is... we basically need to go back here. And... yeah, these... there are like a few areas that we've still not yet covered when it comes to this... this part of the maze here. So let's go back up here and start covering these directions as well. Okay, so we are supposed to head... no. East, I think? Yes, east. Some of the areas in this dungeon are pretty claustrophobic, to put in a sense of the word. So we can go left here and we can go right here as well. I do believe we have been to the right, haven't we? I guess not. That's where we could heal the zombie from. Rob zombie. And there's another talk. Might as well equip it, I guess. Not that it matters. I've got better boots. Oh, these are just same boots. Alright. Not a problem then. Oh, there's even some loot here. How nice of them. I have to admit, I did not think that being so overpowered would take out the fun of this game, but I suppose it is better than being just underpowered and white-knuckling your way through things. Let's see where this takes us. It seems to be just another resting area. It's sort of like what they say, it's better to be a warrior in a garden than a gardener in a war. One of them actually has a practical use, the other one is just useless. So we can go here and check this side out, and then we can come back up there and check that side out. And that will complete this labyrinth for us. Speaking of, where is the original place that we entered from? I think it teleported us somewhere else entirely. Or maybe it's just so far down that we can't see it right now. Because we are quite high up at this point. So, alright, let's head south. All the way. Let's see where that takes us. This seems to be another rest area. But it's behind locked doors. Okay, no. It takes us elsewhere. Takes us somewhere else entirely. Cool. Which way do we go first? Do we go that way? Alright. If you insist. Okay, there is... I can hear some sort of ghost back there. I wonder if that is a lich. Putrid von Lichtenstein. Okay, this is like a continuation of that entire area there. I'll get to you, bud. I'll get to you. Nothing here. Ooh. I was wondering, there are supposed to be like more... what do you call it? Modules to this place. Why are there like so few? And that was a lucky spot, to be honest. I was lucky to be able to spot that thing. I hear more zombies. I see a giant bat. Let me just go and slay it. Happy slayings. I had heard that Lysandus' tomb is a very, very insanely long dungeon, but I had no idea that it would be quite as long. Because it seems like there are like multiple places that we are yet to get to, so to speak. So this is where you came from, I suppose. There are a few paths left for us to choose. We can take a left or we can take a right. Let's go right first. Let's see where this takes us. Into another one of these hovels. I don't know whether... Yes, we have already taken that path, and we have seemingly taken that path as well. But the path that we have not taken are the north and east ones. Let's go east. Let us go east. Let's see where this takes us. Since we're here already. Die, ghost. Too bad this guy noticed me after my first swing missed him. Like, went right off over the top of his head there. So I feel like we've been here before. Yes, we have. Yes, we have been here before. We have covered this area. And are we going to continue down? Alright, let's go down. Let's go down and see what's here. Of course, another one of these structures here. I can hear something like a lich, though, is what's sort of concerning me at this point. Let's mark this. Oh, wait. But we have already been here before. Alright. We'll go back there and we can head north. Oh shit, where did you come from? Wait, there's a coast near me? Oh, I see. Good thing that these guys actually sparkle whenever they use the spells. I just need a potion of free action. That is all I need. Can I have a potion of free action? That is all I want. Ah, right here. Die, would you kindly? Thank you. It's funny, sometimes the game makes the... Okay, we can head east as well. Before we head north, let's head east and see what we have here. Two paths, let's go up here. Have you been here before? No, we have not. Let's see. Let's trudge around and see what we get into, what we walk into, what we manage to find. Apparently, we have already explored this area. So it's sort of a waste of our time, really. It's strange, how have we not come here before? Like, if we have been here before, it should be marked on the map accordingly, right? But it's just sort of not marked on the map at all. Curious. Alright, let's keep heading this way. Checking corners. Okay, so this takes us all the way to the top, presumably. Now we've got two choices. We can either head east or we can head south and then west. And there's also this north entrance right here. I have a feeling this will join up with the north entrance. Did it? I think it did. Yes, it did. Alright, so we can head west now, and then south, and then west again. West, south. Let me just rest here and see if all the. Progress that I've made thus far. And we have already been here before. We have just not linked the two paths yet. Okay, so are there any paths left unexplored in this forsaken region? I would think not. So now the question is, how do we get back to the top set of these, you know, hovel holes? Because, okay, so we go this way. No, we need to get there. So to get there, we need to essentially get there, and then there, and then there, and then that's a dead end. Oh hey, we have not gone north there, so might as well go ahead and explore it, right? And this way, we have not explored that way either. Alright, let's do it. Which way again? I sort of got confused there. I think we're supposed to take this route and then go upstairs, and then go down, and then keep going down until we get there, and then we can take the north route. This way, right? Right. For whatever reason, my navigation sucks right now. So, please bear with me. We take a right. And we keep going straight, and we take a right again. And then we just follow it all the way down here. And then we head north, and we keep heading north. So this is one of the places that we had not explored previously. We'll cover you as well, don't you worry. Don't you worry, don't you worry, child. See, heaven's got a plan for you. Alright, so now the question remains, how do we get all the way over to this here stairway? So see, we came out here. Oh, okay. We can get to that stairway through. There's a hidden door there that we have not checked yet. I suppose we should go ahead and do that. Let's keep heading west and we'll find that thing. Yes, the hidden door should be right here. I don't believe it holds much. Oh, it does. No, it does not. Just a hidden door. Nothing else. Alright, so from here, where do I go? I can go here, and then from there. That takes us upstairs, actually. Which I do believe is detrimental to what we're trying to achieve. Actually, no, it does not. It takes us downstairs. Which is exactly what we're trying to achieve. We go downstairs. Alright, nice, nice, nice. So we head south, I do believe, if I'm not wrong. If I remember where we are. Okay, we're here in this corner, and we need to head south, and then I do believe we need to. Keep heading south. And then further south, we essentially need to just keep heading south, is what we do. Alright, let's go south. And I do hope that we're going the right way. Seems to not be the case now. Unless, oh yeah, It will take us the correct way. The path is just so long and winding that it's difficult to put a trace on where you need to go. Okay, so since we're here now and we need to get there, so essentially what we need to do is we need to take this left and then from here we need to go west, and then from the next intersection take a south, and then yeah, that will lead us to where we want to go. West, from this junction we take a south, and this should be where we want to go. Nice. Now then, since we are here, where else were we supposed to go? Ah yes, we were supposed to follow this here path to our right. Since we're out of there, I'm just gonna save again. I just hope that we're not in a place where, you know, we're gonna have to pull out some shenanigans to try and escape. Now the question is, where is the rest of the dungeon? I think we have explored this area as well as it can be explored. Don't think there are any areas that are remaining thus far. I wonder if there's a path back into the main dungeon through here. Seems to be the case, yes. So I suppose what we need to do is just head east from where we are. Okay. Yeah, we just head east and that's it. We just need to take this route here. And we're golden. We are golden. Okay, now where is Goldilocks supposed to go? Back. That's where Goldilocks is supposed to go. Goldilocks is supposed to go back. Retrace her steps. Although she's more like Silverlocks, but you get the point. This is where we sort of killed those rats and came in. Now then, since we're at this junction here, where else can we go? Where else do we have left to go? We have not gone all the way straight here. East, that is. Or maybe we have, it's just not showing up on the map. We have actually gone east. If there was ever an appropriate time to stop and consider where to go, this would probably be it. Trying to figure out where to go, that is. We have, I do believe, covered this section, so I do not think there are any hidden, you know, doors or anything. There might be hidden doors, but I don't think we have left any stone unturned in this particular section here. Oh hey, is that... Oh, I think that was pretty much the main crypt of the game that we maybe started our insertion, like where we entered from. Nope, that's like an entirely different part of the dungeon altogether. I wonder if there's any way to get back there. Apparently there is. We see a path there that we can take, but the question now that remains is, how the hell do we get to it? Because we are all the way here. Let me just go ahead and check out this side of the map, whether there is any exploration remaining to be done here. And if there is, we'll go explore. Otherwise, we'll forsake this little place and go elsewhere to complete our exploration journeys. It seems to be an elevator of sorts there. That was the loop that we had seen before. Now this here seems to be an elevator, and I'm curious to check out what's there. But getting to the elevator again is a... we can get to the elevator through here. Question still remains, how do we toggle this elevator? Because if you guys notice, there's like this shaft to it there. So that's most definitely an elevator. And given the size of Lysandus's tomb, it's one of the largest dungeons in the game. And not only that, it also has, you know, a total of 18 quest locations from what I remember. So it's not exactly an easy dungeon to crawl. I mean, the enemies are easy, but the dungeon is labyrinthian. Dungeon is labyrinthian. It does not seem to be so from the outside, but it is huge, humongous. And the elevator is pretty much the only reason that I'm coming here. And if we cannot figure out a way to open the elevator, we'll just come back into it, because it is sort of, the time is close for me to stop actually recording. Let's see, I think we have to take a left here to get to the elevator. I mean, yes we did. Elevator is at the very end of the hallway, unless it's hidden behind this steel door. Nope, we're standing on the elevator. Now the question is, how do we activate it? Oh, there's a switch right here. Right. I'm gonna just go ahead and save the game here, because, well, I'm out of time for now. So when we come back, we will be covering more of the hunt, or, well, the Daedroth in Lysandus' tomb. So yeah, let's go ahead and see how this goes. This is going to be a large, long as dungeon crawl, so let's hope that we succeed in it. If we don't, well, we will just abandon it. Doesn't really hurt, because we got our objective of finding the location of Lysandus' tomb, so yeah. And let's just say that we got this information from an unknown source, maybe a friend in the Mage's Guild, or a certain somebody. Maybe it was Godfog that slipped us this information, or maybe some nobleman from Wayrest who, you know, doesn't exactly want the ruling family to win or to continue ruling, essentially, who gave us this information, and to look for Menevia, that is. So yeah, here we are, exploring this dungeon for a Daedroth, and we have finally figured out the quest, the location of Lysandus' tomb, albeit with some degree of external help, but it was an organic process. We did not exactly have to use cheats. We did hack the game a little, we played around with it a little, but we did not have to use cheats, and that is what matters. So yeah, when we come back, we'll cover more of this. Until then, see you later. Alright, we're back. Time to head down this elevator shaft and see where this takes us. That's a fast elevator ride. I'm sort of concerned this is a trap. Turns out it's not. I can hear bats and rats. This is a completely different section, and I don't know where we are right now. Definitely somewhere, but I don't know where exactly we are. Seem to be running parallel to this, you know, this here dungeon module. Well, hopefully the Daedroth is somewhere here, and if he's not, then, well, no issues. No issues whatsoever. For one thing, even though this dungeon is quite large, it has been kind to us, so I'm glad about that. Another rat. I hear another zombie. Like, this might just be a good dungeon to grind up your, you know, successful backstab, a backstab on the rat. The rat died. I've been getting backstabs on rats now, which is strange. I never thought I would get backstabs on rats. This seems like some sort of a bestiary, to be honest. And I wonder if this is the path to, well, main quest objective. I wonder. I mean, at this point I can only wonder, and that's all. Okay. We came out into a central hub of sorts. This sort of looks like... You know, this sort of looks like... like the quest for the road to the main, you know? Quest. But is this it? Like, is there nothing else here? I can hear more insects here. But there's supposed to be something here, so I'm just searching for like some sort of hidden doors or whatever. There probably are hidden doors all around the place. None of them are marked on the map though. I can see only one door there. Oh wait, what is that? That seems to be a hidden door there. Over there? Yeah, I think there's... Yeah, right there. You can see the outline. Magically held block. Is there supposed to be like some sort of mechanism that's supposed to open it or something? Like, am I supposed to touch some of the statues or maybe like a torch or something? Is there supposed to be like some sort of lever or anything that helps us unlock this door? Or maybe it's supposed to be opened from the other side? Or maybe we need to hit some other kind of mechanism along the way to open this door, or maybe, you know, we can just try using the open spell on this and seeing if that works. We do have a long shirt of undeniable access. We can try using this, using that on this door here. Magically held lock. Let's try that. Let us try using the long shirt of undeniable access. I think I'm wearing it. Nope. Long shirt of the wise. I think this was it. Yes. Let me go ahead and change the style of that shirt. Spell effect failed. Okay. Good thing we can keep trying again and again though. I wonder if there's a quicker way of doing this except for, you know, where we don't have to, like, constantly go into our inventory. Is this water walking? Wise. Yeah, let's equip this shirt for now. And let's give ourselves like a wisdom buff. Yeah, I guess we can't really open this door using the long shirt of undeniable access no matter how much we try. Let's try one more time, and if it doesn't work, we'll just call it quits. Oh, it opened. Nice. But all it has is just... Oh, okay. I wonder if there was any other way to open this. That's a zombie! Any more zombies? Just these? And we have just... I think we have just walked into Lysandus' tomb. Well, this is not what I was here for though. I mean, this is not what I came here for. But yeah, this I think is Lysandus' tomb, from what I remember. From when I spoiled the game for myself. Well, this was... I was supposed to come here after talking to Medora Tireni. Oh well. Hey, there seems to be something here, like, we apparently missed two hidden doors here. One over there and one around here somewhere. Or are they... No, we did not miss any hidden doors. But we did miss one right here. I don't know if it was hidden or whether that was just my carelessness. Anyway, I guess we're going back out of here. Now, how do we get back out of here is the question. Is there any sort of lever or something in this room that will let us, you know, climb back up? There seems to be something in the southwest corner over here. Short of that, all we can do is just use like a levitate spell. We can't really do much else. So since this seems to be like a dead end, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna load up a previous save. And we're gonna undo all this progress because I don't want to use a levitate potion just to get all the way back up. Did I just fall down the... I did. And now I'm stuck here. Well then... I guess, yeah, we are reloading. Load game. And we're gonna reload the save here. Because pretty sure there are other places in this dungeon that we can access, like explore. Okay, we're not going down there. We have already been down there and we're not going down there. What I want to do instead is check out some of the modules on this side that we have not explored. The modules that we had seen previously. I wonder what this is, to be honest. There's like this blue thing here and the red thing here. Well, hey. Oh no, we have. I was wondering, like, wait, did we like miss a few spots there? What's going on? No, question is, how do we get all the way here? Because I think there were like a few things here that we had not explored yet. Somewhere over here. I don't recall exactly where. But definitely somewhere over here. Like this section right here, we have not gone farther than that. How do we get back there, is the question. So, I can see a way right there. That takes us through the entire maze again. Or have we been there? No, we have not. We have not been there, been that way. Although I doubt that we will find anything there. Question still remains, how do we get out of this? And there's like, okay, we have explored that side. Question still remains, how exactly is it that we get out of here? That is a dead end. We have successfully explored all of those areas. We are in there. So I guess our first step should be to get out of this place. Since obviously what we were looking for isn't here, so might as well just go back out. However, yeah, let's leave this module first and then we'll see what can be done next. I think this is the way up. Yes it is. Now which way we were supposed to go again? I think we need to take a left. Yes, we do need to take a left. I don't think we go there, I think we need to take this here route. No, that will lead us to a different place. We go this way. And where else? I mean, the only place we can go from here is just down those steps there. So let's do that first. Then we'll decide on what to do next. We're at a crossroads here, so let us refer to the map and try and figure out what we're supposed to be doing here. Alright, that leads to a dead end. This road, however, also a dead end. This road will take us up, so let us head straight. Now, the only reason that I'm running through these spaces is the fact that I have previously been here. So where to now? If I'm correct, the only way to get anywhere is down this way, like south. We need to head south, and from there we just need to take the route that goes west. Alright, let's go south, let's head south and then go west. And now that we're here, where were these other places that we had left unexplored? That place is a dead end. We have explored that part. I think it was somewhere over here. Yeah, look at all these pieces. We have explored them, actually. Yeah, so first things first, I want to go here. So to get till there, I would have to... These here is a labyrinthian, for one thing. But to get there, what I need to do is... what do I need to do to get there? Okay, that takes me there, that takes me back to where I started. That's the way I came from. That apparently goes down. Is there any way to get down there through here? That goes there, and then that goes there. And yeah, I suppose that works. So where are we headed again? We take the road to the south, and we make it all the way to the bottom. Right. Take the road to the south, take the auxiliary entrance, make it all the way to the bottom. I'm surprised that I had not explored that area first, like before. That path takes us elsewhere. We don't want to go there. We want to get up here. And then from there, what do we want to do? We want to go all the way here, take this auxiliary path. So we go left and up the stairs. We go left. Where are we again? Yeah, we're right here. We go left, we go up the stairs, and then we take a left again, and then a right, and then a left into the auxiliary path. Left again, right? yeah, left again. then we take a right and into this auxiliary path right here. And from where to from here? Where to from here? I guess we... Yeah, we head down the stairs and then we take a right and then we'll have what we're looking for to the left. Oh wait, I've been here before, I think. Strange. I've not been here before. But there's nothing here nonetheless. Oh well, it was a part of the map that we had not explored, so it's a good thing that we got this out of the way. However, this is also not where... the Daedroth is, so... Like, I was sort of anticipating that finding a damn Daedroth in this huge place would be a challenge, and well, it turned out to be exactly that, a challenge. Okay, so now that we're here, let's look at any other places that we might not have explored. Anything lower than this? Nothing? We have already been there. Any other areas that we have left unexplored? Does not seem to be the case, really. It's just that one area near, you know, one hidden door that we missed while going into Lysandus' tomb. The actual tomb itself. Don't really see any other places that we are yet to explore, except for perhaps this underground water passage. So tell you what, I'm gonna reload that save and we're gonna go ahead and explore that one hidden door, and if that does not yield any results, we will just go ahead and reload the emergency slot that we had saved in previously. Because, as far as I can tell, we have completely explored this dungeon module, and I don't really see any other ways for me to teleport myself back to anywhere that, you know, we haven't been to yet. So, with that being the case, I do believe it would be a more appropriate course of action to just head back to where we were. So, yeah, let me just go ahead and load that save up again. Oh no! Oh no! Oh no. Alright, I guess we're gonna have to head back there manually now. I don't think that's where I came from. Was it? No, it was not. We came from... Where did we come here from? Oh no, no, this is going to be another... Wait a minute. I think that was the path we took. Yes it was. So we are supposed to head downstairs. The logs here. You can jump over it, come on. Let me rest here until I'm fully healed. And where to from here? I think we're supposed to go straight. And yeah, we are essentially supposed to go straight. It leads us here. And I do believe we're supposed to continue straight so that we can reach this here module. And we'll enter that module essentially. Again, I could be wrong, but I think we are where we want to be. Actually, we are not. We are lost yet again. No, we wanted to take the path to the east. We went south instead. Alright. Let's take the path to the east. Now we take the path to the south. And that will lead us into this here, you know, place where we can go back up. And from here, we essentially... Yeah, we head west, and then from here we head take the road west again. Yes. And from here, it's just a matter of, well, I do believe we have to go here and then take this route. No, actually. Do we? Yeah, I think we do, because this will then take us here, which we can use to, yeah, right. The roads are confusing in this game. That's one thing, at the very least, that the roads are very confusing in this game. And where to from here? I think we are supposed to head straight. Yes, we are. We are supposed to head straight. At least I'm getting preparation for... Wait, I missed a road somewhere. I think this was the door. Yes it is. So, this is at least preparing me for the actual dungeon dive itself. Which I'm confused about, because Medora said she will contact me after 21 days and she never did. She never did contact me after 21 days. So, first things first. I wanna go ahead and make a save there, and hold up. Where am I supposed to go again? Right, all the way over there. And I think this is where the... I want to go lower. There was an underwater section somewhere here, but I'm not too concerned about it. and I'll not break my head over this if I cannot manage to find what I'm looking for within the appropriate amount of time. Ah yes, I think this is where the underwater... No, that's just a dead end. Alright, I'll go there and I'll check it out, and if nothing turns up, then I'll just reload the emergency save that I made before I touched the skull. I do remember there being ways to, you know, get past, like get back to the original place where we got teleported from, but I don't recall where they are right now. Fast traveling down. This time around we're not actually going to go in there. We can see there's a rat in there. I'm just going to run past all of these. And then we'll open up the map to check where exactly this hidden door was that we missed. I think, yeah, see, so... We came all the way here. There turned out to be nothing there. But the thing is, I can also hear a zombie. And I don't know where this zombie thing is. This is also the door that we were looking for. We'll get to them on the one by one on the way back. First, let us enter Lysandus' hall. Yeah, that is Lysandus' hall. There are no other ways apart from... Is that an elevator shaft? What the hell? Excuse me? Wait a minute. How the hell is that an elevator shaft? Are there any mechanisms around? Okay. Alright. Alright. I see. I'm just saving over that slot there. I wonder where this takes us. No wonder I could hear it like a zombie. But this... Oh, so this is probably what unlocks that magically held door for us then. I see, I was wondering why there's no enemies in there. And the zombies are probably what I can hear from Lysandus' tomb. So we don't really need to waste all that, you know, all those potions of... Yep, that's what opens the door for us. Okay, where are the bats though? Where are the bats that are supposed to be here? Not here? Alright. I'll just leave them. Or maybe they're flying off somewhere in the distance. And there's supposedly a rat here. Let's go ahead and like clear these areas out as well on the way back. The low visibility in this game oftentimes makes it difficult to tell whether there are any... levers on the wall, and that has happened to me twice in this map itself. So, yeah. Like, at first I missed this elevator, and then the previous time around I missed that elevator which unlocks the actual thing. So, yeah. Just how Daggerfall works. If the map did not highlight those features like it works in Arena, I would not have known that this game actually had a lot of those features. And that's just the way Daggerfall rolls. At any rate... Yeah. That's it. Okay. Alright, let's go ahead and load the emergency save. I'm loading? Yes, I'm loading. I don't want to overwrite that save. Well, apparently the Daedroth is not here, so not in any of those modules, so we can safely start heading here, this way. I'll keep this on the ground, since we have not explored these modules yet. And I'll try my level best to find the Daedroth, but I won't break my head over it. If I can't find the Daedroth, I'll just leave. Well, it said the lock had nothing to fear from me, but at the same time it just opened up after one swing. Okay, the fact that I haven't encountered any enemies yet sort of makes me nervous. Okay, another zombie. Zombies I can handle, not really that much of a problem. Lots of zombies around. Okay, just head on a bike. I don't know whether that's a human head or a giant's head, but it's a head on a bike. Meant to be a warning for people like me to not come in here. Oh wait, this is a dead end. Is it? Yes, it is. Let me remove that back. Take that back into my inventory. I hear rats. So I suppose this is a kind dungeon. I mean, the zombies are the most difficult things that I've found here in this dungeon, and nothing else. So I guess that's good. Hi there, fellows. Where are you headed to? What's up? How's it hanging? Oh wait, apparently rat chewed it out. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to ask you such insensitive questions. Or maybe I did. Who knows? Pretty sure these zombies will act as a marker for me, but I'm dropping something here regardless. Okay, these guys were in here. Fine. One of these doors opened. Maybe both of them opened, who knows? Zombie died. Let us try and figure out where this damn Daedroth is. These seem familiar to the dungeon modules that I've already crawled thus far. Was there any hidden door behind us? No? No. We have not yet gone through this door. I wonder what's behind that door though. Oh, okay. Okay, I see. I see what's behind that door. I see what's behind that door now. You don't have to pull a fast one on me like that, but I see what's behind that door now. Since it has been going well thus far, I'll just save you. But it's interesting to see how I have not found a single vampire, ancient, or lich in this level thus far. Although it does make me nervous as to what's awaiting me up ahead. Oh. I'm guessing it's one of those traps again. Yeah. I wonder if it's meant to hurt you. Although I don't think it has the ability to, but I wonder if it's meant to hurt you. Then again, I wonder a lot of things. Jumped over them. So now then, we have come down here. Where else are we supposed to go then? We came from there, we have explored that side. Okay, so there's nothing here. So we go back up. Right, we can go there or we can keep going here, right? So we head back up. And from here, we can keep crawling away this way. Let's move on. Onwards unto darkness. The sound of wind howling. Lucky that it did not get obliterated there. Not that the ghost would be able to obliterate me, but yeah. Enemies nearby, probably somebody up here around the corner. I mean, I can't decide whether the ghosts or the zombies are the bigger threat. The zombies definitely hit harder, but the ghosts can paralyze you. So I honestly don't know which is the bigger threat in this game. I hear a ghost, I think. There's the Daedroth! I was looking for you. I probably should have just come here to begin with. And that's typically what happens with me in these games, right? I begin searching and I begin delving into the depths of things and going where I'm not even supposed to go, and I end up in places that I'm not even supposed to be in, and then I figure it out through, you know, sheer brute forcing, the fact that what I was supposed to be looking for has always been right under my nose. Oh wait, I think we're supposed to go here, yeah. Huh. All that exploration for no reason. I mean, it wasn't for no reason, because we did manage to find Lysandus' tomb, so I'll count that as a victory, to be honest. I'll count that as a major victory. It'll be easier for us to figure out a way when we get back to actually finding Lysandus' tomb. Nah. I wish to exit. Alright, time to hop back onto our high horse and go to Menevia. Yes, yes I do. On foot horse, of course, can't exactly travel by ship on land. And that inadvertently saved us a lot of days as well during our journeys. Celebration of second planting is in full glory this day. It is a holiday with tradition similar to first planting. Improvements on the first seeding, symbolically to suggest improvements on the soul, I see. The free clinics of the temples are open for the second and last time this year, I see. Offering cures for those suffering from any kind of disease or affliction, because peace and not conflict is stressed at this time, battle injuries are healed only at full price. I see. I'm healthy. Cool. Time to... right there. This is what I like about Menevia. You enter Menevia and the fighter's guild is right in front of you. I mean, it was literally meant for the fighter's guild. 9 days or less. Okay, it's midday. We can pretty much go in and talk to the guy who gave us the quest in the first place. Hi, I killed the Daedroth. Hey, you're a better Nod than me, Grimfangs. You're not a Nod, you're a Redguard. Daedroth killer. I like it. Here's a gold. Since you didn't even blink at offing a Daedroth, take this map to Castle Ashley. Plenty of fun for a guardian like you. Yeah, so this is something that I've noticed. In Menevia, when you kill, you know, when you complete quests in Menevia, they also give you extra maps. I guess it's one of the developers' way of helping you out of situations in which you have soft-locked yourself, such as in my case. So, yeah. So let us go ahead and... No, I don't want to load, I want to save this time around. And yeah, let us get another quest from this guy. Every once in a while, we get an idiot like this client. Some fool left his back door open and a wild animal got in. He seems rather confused as to whether it is a bear or a tiger, but in either case, it wanted to eat him. We needed to go and slay the animal. Your standard fee is 685 gold. Want to take it, Grimfangs? Of course! Great, go over to the Ashmith residence in Gothhead. I'll give you 6 days to kill it and get back to me. Prego. Gothhead in Menevia? And yeah, 6 days is a lot of time, and I wish to figure out where the Ashmith residence is. You there. Yes, location general, Ashmith residence. Bit of a walk, just go west, right. He says it's a bit of a walk, so I'm guessing We have to travel a little bit. It's just a residence, not the Ashmouth residence. Residence. That seems like an inn. Feather and the Stag. Huh. Oh, this is it. Now, what I wanna do is I wanna... Let us upgrade our hand-to-hand this time around. Going hand-to-hand with a tiger or a bear with a shield. It is sort of badass. I mean, it's a stunt, but I hear that thing somewhere. I don't know where it is, but I hear that thing somewhere. I'll check down here first, and if it's not down here, I'll go upstairs. Oh, it's a bear. I'm mixing it up right here. I'm doing kickboxing against this bear. I'm curious, like, how many... Oh, that was an uppercut at that. I killed a bear with my bare hands. I guess that's why they call them bear hands, huh? Alright, enough of my cringy puns. Time to go back to Menevia. Menevia. I'm sort of happy that not only did I finish that quest, but I also managed to... I'm guessing I'm at the very other side of the map, and I need to go all the way to the other side. We just need to head east until we head into the fighter's guild. So, I'm happy that not only did I discover the location of Lysandus' tomb for our upcoming quest in a more or less legit fashion. I'll call this more legit because it's better than using cheats or whatever to figure out the location of Lysandus' tomb. So, I guess without knowing the location, we just have to keep roaming around in, you know, places, and hopefully they'll give us some sort of clue or information as to how to proceed with the game. So I guess a lot of the information about how you can get softlocked into this game because of your mistakes is untrue, because, well, as you can see, I mean, they do help you out. These guys do actually help you figure things out. So it's not like they just leave you softlocked. I thought it was early morning and I couldn't come here. But I guess I'm at that stage where guilds are open 24/7 for me. No great difficulties, I trust? Thought not. Here's a 685 pool. Thank you. I'll keep that. And let us save here again. In case this guy gives us another quest. Congratulations, Grimfangs! Because of your outstanding weaponry prowess, we have promoted you to the rank of champion in the guild. Among other benefits, this increase means cheaper weapon repair and more profitable work assignments. And thank you very much, that is exactly what I came here for. So, I'll now be going away from Menevia and back to... well, Coecria. And... yeah, that was our journey in getting promoted to the rank of champion in the fighter's guild. I do believe that is what we were supposed to get to. I'm fortified. I'm surprised that I haven't received any visions from Metora yet. There are a few things that... oh yeah, I never really picked up any of those in the safe, huh? And we still need to figure out a way out from that dungeon after getting teleported there. I do remember there being a way, but I don't recall how. At least we know where Lysandus' tomb is better now, so I suppose we can exploit the game in our favor that way. Figure out a better way to get to it, and like an easier way to get to it, and we only have this many ingredients left. Oh well. We'll figure something out. Anyhow, affiliations. We are at the rank of champion, just confirming. So there are two more ranks to go for us right now. One would be the rank of warrior after this. After champion, we get the rank of warrior in the fighter's guild, and after that would be the rank of master, if I'm not wrong. So yeah, we'll alternate between the main quests and this here, you know. the fighter skill quests. So this was it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, thank you so much for tuning in, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. When we get back, I'll try to make sure enough days have been spent to where Medora gives me a vision of her dust having been prepared, and we just need to, you know, go ahead and take the dust and just go back to Lysandus' tomb. Or I think we just need to go back to her in like 21 days and collect the dust ourselves. I'm not sure, because she has given no vision to us. She has not appeared in our visions yet, despite it 21 days having clearly have been passed. So yeah, let's see what's going on. Things seem strange, but I'll go ahead and check it out. So when we get back, the next time we'll do that. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow earthlings.